world is made up of 6.8 billion people. A conservative but shocking estimate states that 100 million of these people are homeless. Of these, 13 million people belong to India. What does it mean to live without a roof over one's head? What does it entail to live in the most deprived environments? To sleep in fields or on streets? To visit open areas lacking privacy and sanitation? To answer the calls of nature? What must it be to raise a family without having a place to call home? These are some of the questions that a group of students of the Ecole Mondiale World School in India choose to reflect and act upon. Young members of the Interact Club of Ecole Mondiale that operates under the wing of the Rotary Club of Mumbai West decided to make a meaningful difference by putting a roof over the heads of those stricken by poverty. Volunteer with Habitat for Humanity, an initiative determined to eliminate poverty housing and homelessness all around the world. A strategic initiative to provide better housing for 50,000 low-income families in India.
Habitat for Humanity is a social housing NGO.
For building houses and spreading awareness.
Very good team building activity.
To build homes for the homeless.
This project operates in India under the umbrella of India Builds.
The campaign India Builds is a product of Habitat for Humanity, by which we plan to serve 50,000 families by giving a soft loan, which was on a 0% interest, to an individual and which has been repaid by the individual in 7 to 10 years of time.
Saturday, 27th March 2010. Let us follow them on their journey.
Right now we are working in this village called Chaudharwadi, which is in the taluka of Karjat in Raigad district of Maharashtra. Chaudharwadi, we did have a volunteer program with the help of Ecole Mondiale World School, where the volunteers were involved in building the foundation to support more families too by giving their time and sweat equity.
Let's see how these young students take this vision forward. 30 interactors of the Ecole Mondiale World School have set out with a mission. This is not going to be a typical Saturday in their lives. They have decided to somehow make it more meaningful.
It's something that we as students really believe in. We asked ourselves, what best way can we serve our community in? We decided, what better way than to place a roof over the head of the homeless?
These young students, aged 16 to 18 years, pursue a variety of community service initiatives as part of the International Baccalaureate or IB curriculum that encourages students to apply what they learn in the classroom to real-world issues and problems.
Education mainly is not inside the classroom. It starts as it goes out. Giving your time and your sweat to build someone a home by not charging anything but pulling in terms of finances, in terms of other resources and your time as well.
This is their chance to experience the joy of building a dream home for a family in need by laying a brick, a roof tile, fixing a door or a window. They work alongside the prospective homeowners to help build someone's dream home.
We started out our day by getting our hands dirty. We went and we actually stood in a pile of mud. It was a lot of fun, but it was hard. It was something in complete contrast to our everyday lives, where we're surrounded with air conditions and fans and a nice environment. This was in complete contrast, and while it was a big adjustment to adapt, it was a very enriching experience. We know that we're here to help them, but we're learning so much in exchange of that.
They come face to face with the stark reality of poverty housing and gain hands-on, grassroots experience to work alongside families and communities in building homes where lives can be lived with dignity and hope.
As a teacher, what was fun for me was I'm used to seeing these students in the classroom in a very formal environment. Here it was possible to see them in a very unusual kind of a situation where they had gone to a village, which the travel itself took about 2 hours, and then they worked really hard in the hot sun from 10 to 3 o'clock. There was mud mixed with cow dung, which had to be reduced to a nicely homogeneous mix, which could then be used to cement, as cement, to build walls. It was fun to see how some students were really reluctant to start this work, but once they got into doing it, actually, they enjoyed the experience, and despite the very hot sun and temperatures soaring up to 40 degrees centigrade, they persisted with the work, and I think they did an amazing job building those walls and remaining with the painting task.
Their contribution to the project can enable the dream of mobilizing 1 million supporters and volunteers to put a roof over the heads of the homeless to translate into reality.
We needed one person to hold the paint, one person to mix paint, and one person to hold the ladder, one person to paint while on the ladder, a couple of people painting below the ladder. So in that way, everyone had a job to do, so everyone has to stick to their own role, and then we switch after like 10, 20 minutes.
Their goal is to build adequate houses that suffice basic human needs. After all, housing is a major barrier for breaking the poverty cycle.
The entire idea behind this brilliant exercise is to help the child understand that house is not simply built by just things lying around, but it needs a lot of community help to build that house for someone to stay in. And a very interesting part of Habitat for Humanity is that the people for whom we build the house are there along with us to help us out. And it's like we together with them, though we are absolute strangers for them, we together with them build the house.
Habitat for Humanity International is supported by celebrities and volunteers who give of their time, including former US President and Nobel Peace Prize laureate, Mr. Jimmy Carter, Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie, John Abraham, Steve Waugh, and Diana Hayden, to name just a few. Volunteers are the backbone who sustain the dream and materialize vision into action, help to make the vision a world where everyone has a decent place to live a reality.
I hope that the next time there will be more people that are encouraged to come with us on this endeavor, because I want it to be done bigger and better. It is such a good project and it deserves to be done by a lot more than just 30 people.
So I encourage all of you guys to come and join Habitat, or even donate if you can. Whatever way you can help a person, it's helping yourself too.
And I wish that more and more students will join me the next time I go there.
You can help by making a meaningful difference and becoming a volunteer. Let us join hands together and partner for a positive change. It may well be a journey that will transform lives, including your own.